You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
The community by the community.
Shift, 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 shift. Yes, the church shifted. Don't touch that remote. I'll be right back to tell you more about church shift and the radical faith revolution.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power. The program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Yes. Shift, 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 shifting. Can you hear it? The church. Yes. The church literally has shifted. And I'm excited to tell you all about it on today's broadcast. And I have some amazing dynamic church people, two church people in the studio with me to join me in this conversation about the church shift. It's a revolution. We are redefining what church is and how church is done. It's the radical faith revolution. And I'm really excited to have in the studio with me a colleague, a minister of God, a man after God's own heart, an entrepreneur, a businessman as well, Chris Gbangboye.
Nice to be here.
Nice to have you on Inspired Success.
Thank you.
Seated next to Chris is another colleague of mine, an amazing woman of God. Don't let the looks fool you. This woman, she's mighty and powerful in the Lord. And, she's amazing and, woman after God's own heart, Jonette, and it's Gonzalez, right? It's Gonzalez. Your middle name, your maiden name is Torres.
Yes.
Yeah, so welcome, Jonette, to
Inspired
Success.
Here.
Oh, my pleasure, my pleasure. Just tell viewers a little bit, about your spiritual background, because we're talking today on Inspired Success, if you're tuning in, about church shift, So this is a church conversation today. And Inspired Success, I cover all sphere of a person's life, whether that's spiritual, emotional, financial, professional, personal. I cover all spheres of a person's life. I'm the total success coach. And so, but today's broadcast is really focused on that person's spiritual life. We're talking church here today. Mm-hmm. And so I just want viewers, get to know a bit more about you and just share a bit more about your spiritual journey as well as your professional journey in a minute. Also, the 60 minutes elevator pitch?
60 minutes.
60 seconds, not 60 minutes. I beg
it
your pardon.
It could go to 60 minutes. But just briefly, again, yes. My name's Chris. And I grew up in a very cynical home when it came to religion. My dad, God bless him, went to a Baptist school. And when he graduated, he had wanted nothing to do with anything to do with religion.
Yes.
And so I grew up cynical as well. It wasn't until when I went to college that I actually began to learn of the reality of what it was.
Yes.
Walking personally with Jesus. And I found out it wasn't a religion, it's more of a relationship.
Okay.
And so through the travels, I was born in West Africa, a place called Nigeria. Lived in England.
Which I know.
Lived in England for a good part of my life, so went back and forth. And I came to America. And it's just just been interested in the journey, just coming closer and closer to God, the testimonies, the ups and the downs, where it's all been a relationship.
Okay.
Versus a
relationship. So you came into that relationship really in college.
Yes.
In college. Mm-hmm. Anything dramatic about you coming into it, or it just kind of just from, you know, colleagues and, mm-hmm. you know, your friends sharing the faith with you, or was there anything dramatic about that?
Nothing extraordinary, dramatic, but there was the curiosity. There was this sense of wanting to prove wrong whatever the Bible said.
Yes.
And I never was able to prove it wrong. And then that drew me closer and closer in.
Yes.
Professionally, when I had struggles, I always found myself leaning back to
counsel. Yeah, to your faith,
leaning back to the faith, and that brought me through.
Okay, awesome, awesome, very interesting. And then what about you, Jeanette? You know, tell us a bit about your spiritual journey and, you know, how that's evolved, as well as your, you know, a bit about your professional journey.
Well, actually, I came to the Lord when I was only 7 years old.
Okay.
So pretty much I was born in the church. I was born again Christian. And I had been in my church for over 33 years of my life.
So your parents, are ministers, I understand. You were saying before the show started that your parents are ministers. So they kind of, you know, and they were ministers of God, you know, Bible born again believers. So they kind of, you know, introduced Christ to you.
Well, when we came, when we came about, my somebody ministered to my mother as a young adult, and at 7 years of age, I was the one that actually accepted the Lord into my life, and that's when my mother finally said that she would give her heart to Christ.
Oh,
and,
I see.
So from there is where it began, and then when I hit about 16 years old, I got pregnant at 16 years old, and as far as being dramatic, that's where my breaking point was, and I wanted to establish a relationship with the Lord more so. So that was my struggle.
Yeah.
That's what brought me to the feet of Christ.
Of Christ. It brought you to the relationship.
Yes.
You began to walk the walk, and as opposed to just talk the talk.
Absolutely.
And going through the motions. I get that.
Absolutely.
I get that. That's very interesting. And, you know, if you're just tuning in, this is Inspired Success. And today we're just talking about church shift, you know. So it's a church kind of conversation today, and redefining what church is and how church is done, and this revolution and this shift that I've been sensing. And, you know, so you have been part of a local church. You were alluding to that just now, a local church community in terms of organization. And what about you, Chris? Are you a part, or have you been a part of you know, kind of organized
moving to Connecticut 15 years ago? We've been part of Church on the Rock, New Haven.
Okay.
Christ-centered, community-based, very powerful church.
Okay.
And very charismatic and forward thinking and forward moving.
Okay, awesome. Yeah. So and so have I. You know, I used to be a part of you know, I don't know whether you've heard my spiritual journey before, my story. And, you know, I was born, you know, in a traditional church, you know, an Anglican church. And my parents were Anglican, and they were church-going Christians, you know, but there wasn't a concept of relationship introduced, you know, until my mother died when I was 18. And that was when I began my journey in search of truth. And I eventually came to understand Christianity more as a relationship, as opposed to, you know, a religious format of something you go through the motions. And, you know, and then fast forward, I was part of a denomination as well for a quarter of a century. And, so here we are now. And we're talking about a shift. You know, I personally have been in transition and I've shifted. And the shift that I have observed is more outside the four walls of traditional church. I'm finding a mass exodus. I'm finding in my community. I don't know about you, and I'll give you a chance to speak to that. But, you know, a sizable exodus of people kind of living more of the traditional church setting to more informal gatherings, informal kind of setting, a way of fellowship and and interaction and worship. I don't know whether that's something, a shift that you have, either of you have seen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would also add, apart from the shift, it's been more of a desire for people to experience the reality of what God is doing today versus the fundamental structured services, the fundamental impression of what church, quote unquote, is. I think there's more of a hunger and a yearning.
Okay, exactly, of the reality of the power, you know. So that shift is, for you, that you've observed, is not so much the style or the way the worship, but it's more of a hunger and desire for people to experience
God
the power
victory
of God that they read about in the pages of the scripture,
and
see the demonstration, which seems to be so missing in the church walls, within the walls. We don't see it any longer. I hear you on
and
that.
This power touches every aspect of the life, whether it's business, whether it's your health, your family, your marriage, everything.
Absolutely. So, you know, so you're speaking to this form of godliness, you know, but denying the power. So people are hungry for the power. They want to experience the power. Interesting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I can attest to that as well. I've seen that desire for more. It's like there's got to be more. Mm-hmm. What about you, Jeanette? What is it? Have you observed as a shift?
I feel like there is a great need and hunger for people to want to know who this Christ is in that relationship. I think we get a lot of the rituals and the, you know, the everyday, you know, go to church on Sunday, and it just becomes routine. Nobody's looking for that routine anymore. They want more. They want more of a relationship with God, with the community, the body of Christ, getting to know one another and fellowship, the gospel, teaching the gospel of Christ. You know, we've lost the gospel somewhere along the way.
Across the lines.
Yes.
It's across lines.
Yes.
People are moving and shifting, you know, outside the lines and the boxes and their traditions, and they're looking more for something that's organic and real and authentic, that's bigger than them, that doesn't seem so confined, you know. Absolutely. That's what I have noticed as well, that there has been a great shift. And I'm one of those people that have shifted, actually, from the more traditional setting, because I went through a personal, you know, epiphany, where I redefined, you know, and we say this all the time, but I think sometimes people, until it becomes an aha, you know, in our mind, we can just say it and know it with our heads, where I redefined what church is. And I came to the realization that I am the church. The Bible says he no longer dwells in temples made with hands.
It dwells
in us. And I am the church. And the gathering is just a fellowship, is an assembly of the church coming together to equip, to empower, to worship, to be infused, to go out and be, you know, make the impact and influence outside the four walls, because that is where the light that Jesus says we are, the lights of the world,
that's
where the salt that we are is needed. It's out there, not really in here, you know. And so for me, it was a really aha defining moment, an epiphany, and it really revolutionized the way I conceptualized church and God and my own identity as a change agent. And, you know, and I see many, many, many more who are also redefining and moving outside the box, like we're saying, different kind of, some who are hungry. What do you think is responsible for this shift, for this awakening of sorts?
Yeah, well, we are in the end times. And with all what's going on economically, politically, people are looking for answers. And answers are not found in your talk shows. Answers are not found in your TV shows. Answers are found in the Bible. And there's this vacuum, there's this yearning for people to find the real solution.
Yes, but you know, but when you're talking about people who are in the places where the Bible is supposed to be preached and taught, we're talking about church people, yet they are not finding the answers in those places. Do you get what I mean? They're the ones who are still broke, busted, disgusted, who are hungry, who are wanting more, who are leaving, who are searching, who seem lost. You know, so obviously they're not finding the answers there. And so what do you think is responsible for that? Why are there not answers that are fulfilling this quest and this hunger for people in traditional church settings?
I just think that everybody has just conformed to just being comfortable, just being in that box and not stepping outside of that box. And with that being said, you know, there's more. There's this inside feeling that there's more out there. There's more that God has.
And so they know that there's more. And so they desire for greater. So you're saying, if I hear you correctly, that some people kind of actually feel stuck.
Yes.
They feel stuck and stifled, that they're not being fed. You know, they're not getting the good meat, filet mignon of the word. Mm-hmm. And they call it quachocods. What do they call that disease where you are not having the right?
Malnourished.
They're malnourished. Mm-hmm. And they're not nourished enough. And so they're looking for the real meat of the word. So the meat of the word is missing. So maybe what they're getting is traditions of men is taught. Culture is taught. Mm-hmm. Tradition is taught. Mm-hmm. Like Jesus said, you make the word of no effect because you teach traditions.
And intellectualism.
Exactly, and intellectualism. So that absolutely is one thing I've noticed. And then what about in terms of their giftings? Have you met people who feel disenfranchised, where they have been rejected by traditional church because their gifts have not been embraced? Maybe they have non-traditional gifts. Maybe they rap instead of sing in the more traditional sense. Maybe they're a different kind of artist. Maybe their gender, they don't feel the stereotypical traditional.
They don't fit the traditional mold.
Of what church is and
all
what
over.
The gifts are.
Yeah, all
and
over.
Are you finding that?
I do find that. And oftentimes what I have found is more so favoritism. I've found a lot of favoritism in a lot of different churches. You know, they have a favorite person to do worship, or they have a favorite person to do the sound, or they have a favorite. So the people that are gifted in those things, they don't have the opportunity.
They don't have the platform, exactly. Mm-hmm. That's what I found. They don't have the platform to express their giftings. Mm-hmm. And I think, Chris, you had mentioned this when we had a conversation earlier in the year about how I was talking about this, the Radical Faith Conference that's coming up on April 26th. Save the date, April 26th. RoyalProclamations.com is where you go for more information. It's sponsored by State Farm and Connecticut Light and Power. And that's where we're having the Radical Faith Conference. But you know, when we're talking earlier about that, and I was talking about the gaps I'd noticed, you know, in terms of number one, empowerment seems to be missing tools for everyday life and victory and success. You know, I feel that is another reason why the people are shifting, because they're not finding, they're not getting tools, practical tools to advance their life, to get themselves out of their financial rut and get their credit card debt down. Their health is in chaos. And, you know, and you have said that, you know, there was not a structured or recognized ministry catered towards business or anything in some of the settings you're used to, that what you do has been informal and outside of the four walls of church.
Of traditional church.
Church. Because I think that's part of the challenge too. Mm-hmm. People's giftings and you know, are not being utilized to the maximum. Exactly.
And that's one of the things that actually excites me about the conference coming up. I think it's going to address that gap, that chasm that's between when you have a lot of business people, you have people who are just looking for the basic brass soup to nuts.
Absolutely.
1, 2, 3 ABCs in terms of doing better, not just financially, but putting things together where they can move from one place to the other.
Complemented with the council. Of course, from a biblical worldview. And they need practical tools. Like you, when I met you the other day, all you needed was some tools. How do I set up my nonprofit? How do I register that? How do I organize it? And all that. Those are practical information that people need sometimes to take, you know, their gifts and everything God has blessed them from one level to the next. Mm-hmm. And that's what the Radical Faith Conference is going to do. It's going to meet that gap. It's going to come alongside people who you know, have not been affirmed and validated because their gift or their calling is non-traditional, you know. And they're going to be also provided with the tools and encouraged, you know, to in their path as they seek to work out their God-given destinies. And then what other, you know, challenges do you find has come, you know, with this shift in terms of, we've talked about the fact that people lack the knowledge, so they need tools. But now that people are shifting out, they're branching out. And actually, I don't know whether you know this, but Bishop Jakes, his last Pastors and Leaders Conference, the theme was branch out. Mm-hmm. And I was so encouraged and so validated by my theme, because of he was saying exactly the same thing to pastors and leaders about branching out and out of the walls. And I'm talking about stepping out of the box. But many people are branching out because they're not finding the fulfillment, they're not finding the encouragement, they're not finding the validation, they're not finding enough tools and everything. And so they're branching out and in searching. So the challenges that come with that shift, what are some of the challenges you would say that you've observed or noticed?
I would say three, communication. Getting the word out there to let people know that there are extra resources, you know, through seminars, through a conference, to be able to help them get the information they need to move to the next level.
Absolutely.
Getting the word out there.
And that's it. If you're just tuning in, I know we only have a few minutes. This is Inspired Success TV show, you know, with Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach. And we're talking today about the shift, church shift. This is a very spiritual broadcast today. We're just talking about the shift that I've noticed that's coming to the body of Christ in terms of how people are redefining church and how church is done. And when I even want to take that more secularly, I see a lot of people, you know, who tell me in the marketplace, oh, you know, they were raised Catholic, Baptist, and all that. That no, they don't do organized religion anymore. They're now spiritual. And so we're losing this whole generation of people who are going into all these new ages and mysticism because the traditional church has abused many of them. Oh, many have been abused, you know. We've read about all kinds of scandals. You know, many have been abused in church. Many have been exploited. They've been lied to. They feel oppressed and all of that. And so, yeah, but now they're branching out. They're like this sheep without a shepherd. They need information. They need tools. They need education. They need empowerment. You can get all of that on Saturday, April 26th. We're not even having it in a traditional church building, you know. And it's a Radical Faith Conference. And I'd love to see you there because I'm telling you, the tools and the resources that you need to really advance in the direction God has called you to are waiting for you there. What else have you noticed, Jeanette, as far as the some of the challenges that come with that shift? You know, apart from oversight and having like a covering and all that, what else have you?
It's not easy. I just think that's as a whole, it's hard.
So what are some of the challenges? Break that hardness out. They're discouraged. Yeah. Discouragement.
It can get very discouraging because you're looking for encouragement, and when you're trying to be outside of that box, it's there's very few. There's only a select few that you can actually go to.
And then they're looking for leadership.
Absolutely.
You say leadership.
Absolutely.
Leadership that they can trust in.
Yes. Someone they can believe in.
Yeah, believe in
that as will not, you know, abuse them the same way, you know. So they're looking for mentorship. They're looking for guidance. They're looking for oversight. Yes, encouragement. Yeah, and they're looking for tools. And all of that is going to be available to you, you know, if you're just tuning in. All of that is going to be available to you at the Radical Faith Conference on April 26th. From 9 to 5 is a full one-day conference, royalproclamations.com. Just go there. Chris is going to be one of the speakers. I know that Jeanette is going to be involved and, you know, just helping in one way or the other. But that is the new church. I call it the new church. If the new church is outside the box, it is the identification that we are the church, aren't we? And, you know, in closing, what would you say in terms of now someone is watching this broadcast and they're saying, you know, how can I get to connect with a community? You know, you're talking about it's hard. How do I build community? How do I connect with like-minded people? How community is important. Fellowship is important. And we can't do it by ourselves. How? What would you say? Where would they go? How do you think this can be a resource to help people to build community and start connecting and networking? You and Jeanette are now networking and how do we kind of put the dots together
I think the first step would be to attend the conference. Secondly would be to take advantage of all the tools that will be made available there.
Yes.
And like you said, to network, to get to definitely get plugged into a local church.
Yes.
But then also to take the tools and use them practically.
Yes.
To overcome the hump.
Yes. What about you? What would you say? That's been the challenge. Mm-hmm. And that's why post-conference, I have, I call it Conquerors Academy. It's a mentorship and training program that I've created, you know, for ongoing support and discipleship. But because people do need the community, how would you tell them to you know, plug in? How can this be a kind of resource? Because I know you have events as well. How does that be the beginning of a process for?
You know, I think that, you know, going to the April 26th conference, the Radical Faith Conference, is obviously one of the first steps for you to do. But making sure that you're networking with other people, you know, Facebook has been an awesome tool for me to connect. That's how we actually met.
Yes.
And now I've got another connection. But, you know, Christ-like mind, other people that want to do the same thing. We have one goal.
Yes.
One goal.
And,
you know, we are one body.
What is that one goal?
We are one church.
One body, one Lord, one faith.
That's
it. One heaven.
That's
ultimately, our goal is to please God and give him glory and advance his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
So connecting with others that, you know, that love the Lord.
Yes. And like you said, it's about stepping out of your comfort zone.
That's
you know, maybe for you it's different. Maybe you've never been to quote unquote a faith-based event in a facility, in a corporate setting, you know. Maybe that's out of your comfort zone. Maybe that's the first step. It's really actually stepping outside of our comfort zone and making the step to explore and to, you know, explore the possibilities. At the end of the day, what do you have to lose, you know? Mm-hmm. And so I want to just encourage you. April 26th, kudos and thanks to our sponsors. I look forward to seeing you there. Dynamic speakers, inspirational workshops, networking, massage therapists, you name it. A full 1 day of empowerment awaits you. Time is up, but we're not out of words. And so tell them, see you on April 26th.
Definitely see you on April 26th.
See you April 26th.
Thank you so much for being on Inspire Success. Thank you so much for being here. And this is Princess Bola Adelani reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, put your smile on your face. Come on now, life's too short. Keep networking, keep learning, keep believing, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I look forward to seeing you on April 26th and seeing you next month on Inspired Success. Thank you so much for tuning in. God bless.